No, intro.
Your favorite dance move.
To it. There was no introduction.
I was ready for it today.
She's been excited. Let me just tell you how much effort goes into her picking a song.
I don't know how many minutes that took, but I went through several songs today.
Mm-hmm. I did. She won a boy band.
I did.
And why that song?
Because we're going to talk about stepping out with your dog.
Stepping out. Okay, then.
Today we're going to talk about leashes, specifically the one type of leash, well, one of just a couple types of leashes that we really, really don't like, and we'll talk about the reasons why. So they're very popular, not entirely sure why, because I don't like them, so I don't understand the appeal, honestly, but retractable leashes are, like, the worst. They're like McMurray. They're the worst.
They are pretty terrible.
So we wanted to go over some of the reasons why and maybe try to convince some people to not bring their animals in on retractable leashes. That would be amazing. Mm-hmm. I've told the staff before that if it was up to me, if I had like won the lottery or something, everyone that came in with a retractable leash, I would take it off, I would throw it away, and I would give you an appropriate leash. Because they're awful. We just see so many problems from them. What are some of the things that we see?
We printed some things off. Some of the things we see is just they get wrapped up. They wrap up us. Mm-hmm. They wrap up their owner, which can happen with a regular leash as well, but there's not as much.
There's not as much length.
Exactly. Yeah. To wrap us up.
When you have like a 20-foot retractable leash versus an appropriately sized 6-foot leash, that's a whole lot different. You know, when they can get from one end of the exam room to the other on their retractable leash, that we don't need that.
When they're in an exam room, they can be taken off of their leash anyway. Yeah, they don't need to still be on the leash. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, it's a really thin cord.
Yes.
So
very thin.
It can break.
Mm-hmm. Which I've seen it. I've seen that happen before. I saw a husky that was on a retractable leash that she took off running and it just snapped. And luckily she was still in a building, so she, you know, the door wasn't open, she didn't go flying outside, but she could have. So that's, mm-hmm. you know, especially for a large breed dog, it's really inappropriate. For sure.
Yeah. They can bite through them in a half a second.
Oh yeah.
They can fray. They knot up really easily. Mm-hmm. They can actually cause like burns on us.
Mm-hmm. And on the pets.
And on the pets, absolutely. So those are some of the things that we notice.
Yeah.
We see.
Yeah.
It's not good for leash training either with your pet. Getting them to learn to walk on a leash, you know, mm-hmm. when you just let them go and they're wandering everywhere, that's not training
them.
That's
not teaching them, to do the loose leash walking. There's no such thing as that. So, that's not good.
If you're just popping on, say hello. I see we've got a few people on, but we can't see who you are.
Where do you see this? Right here. I never see where. I can't.
See, it says
the camera
viewers.
Is right in front of where that is for me, so I never see it.
Well, with five people on, let's talk about this really fast because we didn't do it at the
beginning. You're down to four.
Show. Oh, no. Okay, well, four viewers, please stay on for a minute. So, we're doing the giveaway still. So, if we get five shares, you have to share from the original post so that we can see that you've shared it. Mm-hmm. One of the viewers didn't listen. They left.
That's okay.
They're lost.
That's all right.
But if you share our video, you can come. And we get five shares. We will do a drawing. Mm-hmm. And this one is going to give away a candle. So we've got lots of different smells right now. We've got some new fall ones coming.
Yeah,
this one is just the Mai Tai. I don't know if you can see it.
It's delightful.
It is.
We love that one. I think we all love that one.
Yeah, we do.
It's fantastic.
But we do have some fall ones coming as well. Yes. So if you share the video, you'll be entered in for a drawing.
Yeah.
So we'll go back to the leash.
So we...
I just got excited.
I know.
There were six people on.
That's okay. So the other thing that we'll see is a lot of times that like locking mechanism.
Oh, yeah.
Number one, it exists. So when you do, you know, and I understand you have this leash, maybe you can afford to go out and buy a new leash. I get it. But there is a locking mechanism on there. So you are able to lock that line to an appropriate length. Because what we see happen, and right now it's not so much an issue because we're not having people that are in the lobby. But it can happen out front, you know, just wandering around, walking your dog, whatever. Your dog sees another dog, they take off because it's not locked, and they can get like 20 feet away from you, and it's hard to pull them back, so again, especially the like medium to large breed dogs, and so then they're getting in everybody's face, and even if your dog's friendly, doesn't mean that other dog is, you don't know, so lock it at about a distance of about, you know, 4 to 6 feet is more than enough, and really probably even shorter than that if you're going into a building. Just keep your animal right next to you.
Especially where there's going to be other pets. Because we do have quite a few pets that come here that maybe they like other people, but they're not so friendly with other animals.
Yeah.
And like Dr. Hogan said, just because your dog is friendly does not mean that some other ones are.
Right.
I have a blister on my finger from a client whose dog took off and the lock was broken.
And that's an issue, is that those locks, they break all the time.
Or people don't know. They can be really confusing because every one of them is different. Mm-hmm. So some of them you push one button to lock and then the other button to unlock. You have to push and push it forward or backwards.
Yeah, there's like a little slidey thing. They're all different.
They can be really confusing, but they should lock.
Yeah.
You just may have to do some research, figure out how to lock it.
Yeah, definitely. So the other thing that drives me crazy is they're basically, what kind of weapon is that? Where it's like the big spiky ball that's on the chain and the stick. And
I don't know what that's called. I don't know what it's called either, but I know what
I'm not a historian. Damn it, Jim. I'm a vet, not a historian. You don't understand that reference. But like, it's like this and then like, what that's like to me is that big plastic end of the leash where the handle is basically like a weapon that they throw their heads around or whatever. And that comes flying. Oh, that's super. Yeah. I love that.
Yeah. I mean, usually when they come in and they've got one of those retractable leashes on, we end up taking it off anyway, especially in the treatment area because it's loose and it's dangling, or then like
it's smacking them, it's smacking us. It's not a good time.
Yeah. Mm-mm. So we end up taking it off anyway.
Yeah.
And then one of the things that I really dislike about those leashes, and I have had happen to me a couple times, is you, like Dr. Hogan said, you don't get it locked in time and they take off, and then it reaches that point where there's no more, and then it like jerks
and then it
you,
like snaps. Yeah.
Or it
snaps
hurts
the pet.
Them.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Or you go to lock it because they're taking off and then it jerks them back, especially with the smaller dogs. That can cause a lot of issues with their throats.
Yeah. Yeah. Really about the only use that I see for retractable leashes is if you have a fenced in yard that, you know, maybe you're just worried about your dog getting under the fence or, you know, something like that, or you're trying to limit their activity to some degree and you're wanting to give them more freedom and it's just when you're out in the yard. Okay, maybe. But not for out in public.
No.
And the other one that we've seen, and I don't know who came up with this as an idea.
The
bungee. The bungee ones. I don't understand.
They're cool.
I mean,
think
they're cool
interesting,
looking.
But
I don't know the walking. I don't understand
dog.
The point though.
No.
Why does your dog need to be on a bungee?
I don't know.
It's weird to me. And that does the same thing. Like you have no control over your pet. It's going to be dangerous because it has that springy sort of action.
So even if you try to hold them or pull them back, it's still springy.
It's just, it's bad, man. It's bad news. Get just like an OG nylon or leather's great, leather leash. somewhere in the 4 to 6 foot range, that is sufficient.
There are, do you know the brand that they're like guaranteed for life? Like even if your dog chews it up, they'll replace it.
Oh, I've heard of that, but I don't know what brand it is.
They're not much more expensive, but they are guaranteed, especially if you have a puppy or something that's going to, you know, try to chew their leash. Because we've got a lot of, we see a lot of puppies that are like.
Yeah, because that's what they do. Because they're not used to the leash and the collar. And so, yeah, it's weird. And they put everything in their mouths because they're babies.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But even if your pet chews them up, they will replace them for free. So I don't know what it is, but I would look into that. But they are just regular leashes.
Look, Madeline, come here. Come here on the video. You gonna come up here? He says no. He's camera shy.
Come on, River.
He's busy nosing the couch.
Yeah.
Lupine. Yeah. Thanks, Jessica. See? I knew somebody would know.
Yeah.
But yeah, so. that's awesome. That's a good deal. Because yeah, especially chew guaranteed. Yes. Awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And like I said, it's an appropriate leash for all dogs. Yep. We also, and too, you know, along those same lines is talking about the different collars and things too. There's so many different styles of collars. There's not a ton that I think are necessarily problematic, but there are some that are better than others. And I think for us, the bigger issue is just they're appropriately sized for your pet.
Yeah. I mean, I will say I don't appreciate a plastic snap on like an 80-pound dog.
That's fair.
I don't think.
Yeah, like the buckles. Yeah, like it probably needs to be a metal.
Yeah.
Hardware.
Because if your dog really wants to get away, I think that they could, especially over time, it gets loose or it cracks.
Yeah.
So I personally don't appreciate that. I don't think it's safe.
Yeah.
But that's.
Yeah, and I think, you know, what I have, so I've got the bully breeds at home, and so they have very thick necks, they have blocky heads, but their necks are bigger than their head, basically, just like the greyhounds, like a sighthound sort of breeds, whippets, those sorts of guys, so they need something that's more like a martingale style collar, so if you're not familiar with what that is, they have either like a loop of fabric or a loop of chain that's on the collar, that will tighten, so it's not really a true choke chain. I don't love those, but it gives it a little bit of tightening if they pull, so they can't slide out of it and pull it off over their heads. Mm-hmm. We see a lot of collars that are put on way too loose, way too loose.
Yeah.
And again, when they're contained in an exam room, not such a big deal, but when they're out and about, we worry about them sliding out of that and getting loose. So
they don't always like to come and see us. So when you're trying to get them in the front door, and it's not like we're in the middle of nowhere.
Right.
No, there is a busy street right in front of us. And so you're trying to get them in the building and they don't want to come in and they slip out of their collar that
they just back right out of
it. My whole fist under.
Yeah. Yeah. So what's an appropriately sized collar?
So you should be able to get at least 2 fingers under the collar.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm not saying that.
And I would say at least, I would say just two fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At home, I mean, most of my dogs don't wear collars at home.
Mm-hmm.
But when they go out somewhere, I either have them on a slip lead so they can't slip out of it.
Yeah.
Or I also have martingale collars because I have some bully breeds at home as well. And I love those collars. Yeah. I think they're great.
Yeah.
Plus, it's a good option if you want it to be a little bit looser at home, but whenever you do hook them up, you want it to not slip off.
Right.
They're great. They're great options.
Yeah. Or a harness. There's plenty of harnesses available. But those, even if they're not sized correctly, if they are too big, your animal can still slip out of a harness, too. So, it needs to be not super tight, you know, shouldn't be cutting off circulation.
Right.
But so you just, if you could fit 2 fingers underneath there, that's perfect. You don't need any more wiggle room than that, because that's going to put your pet at risk for slipping out of it and getting lost.
Yeah.
That's no good.
No good.
No bueno.
Yeah. Half of my dogs don't wear collars at home.
Well, that's fair.
But they are appropriately sized when they go out.
Right. So. Exactly. And they're all microchipped.
They are.
So if something was to happen at home, like if they one of your kiddos left the fence open or something like
or
that.
Or one of my dogs opened the fence for himself and let all of my dogs out.
That's never happened before. Yeah, so then they're still chipped. So, so double duty, you know. It's great to have the collar on with the tag, but those can get lost. So microchip your pets. Mm-hmm. That's important, too.
We're just talking about all the things today.
I know.
It's great.
It's just like one thing leads to another.
Do we have extra slip leads here?
We do.
Someone? Okay.
Yeah.
So, if you're ready to turn in that retractable leash, come on by and get a slip lead.
Yeah.
We've got a whole stack of them.
Yep, we just got a whole bunch of them.
Mm-hmm.
They were supposed to be purple. They're not really purple, which is kind of sad.
That's okay.
That's
okay. Not everything has to be purple. Oh, by the way, show me your hair.
Well,
turn around.
You mean turn around backwards?
Yeah.
Ugh, too old for that crystal.
It glows in the black light.
It does.
Isn't that fun? Well, it doesn't show up quite as bright on the camera.
On the camera.
My but grandpa would say,
in real
you're
life.
Too old for that.
I am old. And I just keep getting older. But there's some green, there's some teal, some blue, some orange, pink. Some pink. Mm-hmm. A little bit of everything there.
Yeah. If anyone has questions too, I know there's only two viewers right now, but if you have any questions about anything, shoot them on over.
Okay.
I keep wanting someone to ask me a question and no one does.
I'll get you a plant at some point that asks this question that is, like, just for you.
You'll have, like, your dad or someone on there. And just be like, please, for the love of God, just ask her a question.
Would somebody please ask her a question? Any question. What's your favorite color?
I won't say it. Because no one else actually asked.
Oh, goodness.
Let's see if there's anything else on the list.
They malfunction
over time. Mm-hmm. The leash handle is bulky.
Mm-hmm.
The thin cord can easily break, tear, or fray.
Mm-hmm.
The length allows pets to be put in danger. The jerking stop of the leash can cause injuries. The cord can cut, burn, or even amputate.
That's harsh.
That is very harsh.
I mean.
It is a trip hazard. And they don't teach proper leash or what. Yeah. I think we've covered everything.
You hit all the points. Mm-hmm. Good job, us.
Yeah.
Look at us go.
I mean, we just see a lot of issues with them anyway.
Yeah. They're not good.
Yeah.
Please don't use those anymore. Just for at home, maybe. I don't know who's on the other side of that door, but he's excited about it.
Yeah.
Poor little Riku Allen. He's here to get his nails done today because he's naughty. And his dad doesn't know how. He's not on Facebook anyway. It doesn't matter.
Oh,
it's fine.
Well,
I can call him out. It's fine.
He was horrified that you dance on the Facebook. He didn't know about that.
Well, it's because he's not on Facebook. He doesn't know.
I know, but he was horrified to learn that she dances on the Facebook.
I don't know why he's horrified by that.
You're a pretty good dancer.
I got some sweet moves, y'all.
Uh-huh. Yeah. All right. Well, do you have anything else?
Nope.
Okay.
Everyone, just have a good rest of your day, and we will see you next week.
Make sure you share the video.